The European Central Bank will reveal its latest policy verdict today, and the decision could be a make or break moment for the euro. On the other hand, US equities remain under the pressure of the Federal Reserve hawks as the relentless rally in oil prices hardly points at an encouraging easing in inflation. And investors are obviously not very comfortable before Friday's CPI data in the US. So welcome. This is Swissquote's daily market talk. So it's maybe the day of the year for the European Central Bank, which will reveal the latest economic projections, which will of course include the full set of implications of the Ukrainian war on the European economy, the pressure on consumer prices, especially due to the soaring food and energy prices in Europe as well, and which will likely look, it will stick around and even worsen if the European Central Bank doesn't do something about it and as soon as possible. So we pretty much guessed that the European Central Bank will announce a July rate hike at today's monetary policy meeting. So that announcement would be a non-event, obviously, as it is almost fully priced in the market prices. But what's left to price is whether the European Central Bank would choose to raise its rates by 50 basis points to stop the euro depreciation. Because if, after having lagged greatly behind its major peers like the Fed or the BOE, the ECB decided to start tightening gradually, even back-to-back interest rate hikes may not do the job. So we saw that with the Bank of England, for example. They have been raising the rates quite sharply since the end of last year, but the back-to-back rate hikes in the UK didn't really prevent sterling from falling against the US dollar, and the pound barely gained against the single currency. So what the European Central Bank needs to do right now is a coup, a bold action, hoping to reverse the course of the euro, especially against the US dollar, because a stronger euro is obviously the first step in controlling the soaring inflation in Europe. If nothing, the energy purchases, which are negotiated and which happen in the US dollar terms, would be cheaper for the Europeans if the euro gained a little bit of meat. And that's a start. At this point, the zero rates are toxic rather than supportive for the European economy. That's for sure. And unfortunately, Christine Lagarde won't go down in history as the savior of the Europeans as Mario Draghi did. Mario Draghi actually ordered free drinks for everyone, and Christine Lagarde needs to pay the bill right now. So again, unless the European Central Bank's almost certain July rate hike hint isn't complemented with a whole bunch of super hyper hawkish comments, that would obviously overshadow the ugly economic indicators that we are about to see and the fear of a significantly slowing economic activity and economic growth in Europe, well, it won't do much to boost the euro more than the leg up that we saw a couple of weeks earlier when Christine Lagarde called the end of the zero rates in the euro area on a blog post. So if I were her, I would raise the rates today, surprise everyone, and play on the fact that I can surprise, so be careful, which would then prevent me to actually make bold hawkish decisions in the future. Because at the end of the day, we all know that the market pricing is a matter of opinions as much as fact. And again, we won't remember Christine Lagarde for an easy whatever it takes, I won't be there to face the consequences anyway action. But for this record inflation levels, that would have devastated the European households' purchasing power on a continent undergoing a deadly pandemic and a war. So the good thing is she will be remembered as much as Mario Draghi, but not for the same reasons. Anyway, so if the ECB doesn't get seriously hawkish today, the euro dollar will certainly hang around the actual levels, a bit lower than the minor 23.6% Fibonacci retracement on last year's depreciation. But if Christine Lagarde decides to take the reins of the market in her hands, which I hope she will do, we could then see the euro dollar continue pushing toward the 110 level in the medium run. So it all depends on the European Central Bank's next move, whether the ECB could withstand the fearless Fed that throws fearless hawkish comments to the market every now and then and kind of walks the talk as well. And, you know, activity on Fed funds futures priced in nearly 95% chance for a 50 basis point hike on the Fed's next meeting next week. So The US dollar obviously remains strong as the US 10-year is again above that 3% psychological mark as the relentless rally in oil prices revive inflation fears yet again, and the Fed hawks before Friday's inflation read. The barrel of US crude advanced to $123.50 yesterday, suggesting that the energy prices won't help easing inflation, nor the second-hand car prices, by the way, as the Mannheim's used vehicle value index actually ticked higher end of May instead of further easing from the end of last year and the beginning of this year level. So investors are rightfully getting tense, getting uncomfortable about seeing an inflation number which is not soft enough this Friday after all the hawkish talk that has been going on and despite the equity rote as a result of it. And well, we could actually see more weakness in equity prices if inflation doesn't move toward where we want it to move, or more precisely, where the Fed wants it to move. So in the sense, UBS says that it's too early to call time on technology underperformance. They actually write that despite the sharp fall in technology stocks, their valuation premium remains high, and it's better to choose value stocks, especially for investors who have an investment horizon of less than a year. They also say that the value stocks tend to outperform in inflationary environments, and that value stocks just recently started to reverse a decade long of underperformance compared to their tech peers. So Wisdom Tree's value fund trades with less than 10% discount since the January peak and could actually weather a further sell-off better than the technology stocks if the Fed expectations doesn't soften a little bit. Now, one place that gives hope to investors is the Chinese stocks these days. We have been seeing a better and improved appetite in the seriously abated China's most popular companies as, well, the latest news that the government is actually looking to end the probe in Didi came as a confirmation that the crackdown, the government crackdown on the biggest Chinese technology stocks could actually be easing for real this time. Plus, the Chinese authorities gave a go to 60 new video games as another sign that the crackdown on technology and gaming stocks could really be coming to an end. But interestingly, none of the new games are from the game giants that we know, like Tencent or NetEase, and only two are made for mobile versions. But the latest news are obviously positive indeed and is giving a serious boost to our once favorite Chinese stocks. In the sense, Alibaba, for example, jumped more than 15% at yesterday's trading session and trade above its 100-day moving average for the very first time since November 2020, while Tencent gained more than 6% yesterday and added another 1% today in Hong Kong, and the Hang Seng's technology index jumped above its 100-day moving average for the very first time since March 2021. Now, some believe that optimism that we see right now in Chinese stocks could be premature, but the Chinese stocks now have the government and also the central bank support behind their back, which is no longer the case for the US stocks, for example. So maybe, but just maybe, it is soon time for a convergence. So this is all for today. I'm İpek Özkardeşkaya, and thank you for joining me. I hope this episode of Market Talk has been helpful and it has been insightful to you. So please do not hesitate to leave your comments, your reactions, and your questions below as usual, and follow us on Instagram, on Twitter, and on LinkedIn for regular market updates, and subscribe, of course, to our YouTube channel for daily market comments. I meet you again tomorrow, and until then, good day trading.